we had an urban environment. So you don't think about urban environments thinking of pollination. Bees are an endangered species, honeybees in particular. They help with pollination, and so not only flowers, but fruits and vegetables, even trees. I mean, we have very little, but we want to make sure it's producing and very productive.
I think the misconception a lot of people have is that if you have hives, you have to have plants all over right in front of the hives. And that's not really the case, because like I said, they will go within a few miles to find them, and it's amazing that they do. And when I'm placing hives or thinking about hives, I get the satellite and I look at it, and it is amazing how much green there really is.
The partnership with Bedrock's great because we're gonna be placing 6 hives on top of 615 West Lafayette.
Rooftop bee hives were something that we really want to do, so we found a way to make it happen.
We went from having 6 hives when we started Bees in the D in 2016 to 29 hives last year, and we're going to have over 100 this year.
The bees pollinating the urban gardens is a huge benefit. Some scientists believe that 70% more yield comes when there's a bee hive within a 2-mile radius of a garden. So obviously more vegetables. The other benefits maybe, you know, it's just education, being a part of this. It's all these small businesses are working together. So we've gotten to partner up with distilleries and chocolate making places like Bon 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 and Kobo, obviously, and Bedrock, and all these wonderful organizations that believe in us and see the mission that we have for these honeybees.